We are in the night market.
Take a bit of everything. So I have like all the toppings here right now. I can taste dragon fruit, I can taste mango. The boba has not come up yet. And the straw is not going in anymore. We've got the mango sticky rice. And there's this coconut milk here.
So here's our final plate of dim sums.
The best part of fried rice room is it's so hot outside, but the ice cream is there inside, so cool. There's this different, you know, different things going on inside your mouth. It's hot and cool. The mango is sweet. It's very refreshing.
It's something that I would be having which Farah wouldn't, and that is this generous portion of durian. We're just looking for some of the best places to have roti canai, and so this is our hotel, and that's one of the best places to have roti canai, which is PG's restaurant and bistros. We'll go there now. We have sat ourselves down, and Faiz is going through the menu right now. We are planning to have some roti canai. That's a quintessential Indian Malaysian food. People might confuse it with Indian food, but it's not. It's a purely Indian Malaysian food, born and bred in Malaysia only.
So we have this tea tarik here. This time we've taken it hot. Taste test. Amazing. One of the best I've had.
Oh wow. It's really good.
Very nice.
The tea is strong.
It's not watery.
And it's not too sweet also. So
yeah.
It's a perfect tea. This is?
The roti tissue.
Okay, and that's the roti tissue. And?
This is the roti canai.
Yeah.
And that's the chicken martabak.
Alright. So we have three, we have ordered three things beyond the tea tarik. So that's the roti tissue as far as said. And let me show you people. This is the chicken martabak, and that's the roti canai or roti canai, however you want to say it. So we'll start off with these. We put this plate.
Yeah.
And slide it in between the two.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wonderful. Okay. This looks like a huge dosa.
Alright, so you start off with the, I think that's going to be condensed milk and sweet.
Mm.
So you do the taste test, and then we move into these, and then we go back and eat that
okay.
Later.
Oh wow, it's very crispy.
Alright, that's condensed milk, right?
Yeah, it looks like it. Yeah, it is. Okay, this is very crispy, the texture. I don't know if you can hear it when I have it. It's super crispy, very thin, and really nice.
So what I'll do is let me do the taste test for the roti canai and the martabak here. Start with the roti canai. It's very nice and soft, yet it has a crispy layer on the outside. And there are two curries which came with, and let me go for the darker curries also. That's a coconut based curry. Nice. And this is a little more dal based. Yeah. I remember it was spicy. It was more subtle. Good. Now coming to the chicken martabak. Good. This is completely different from the martabak that we have been having in Singapore all these days. like a pancake rather than a paratha. Quite soft and very less dough on it. The mutton dal in Singapore is quite heavy because of the paratha itself, and then you add the chicken or the mutton to that and it gets very heavy. So it is much lighter, much softer, very hot. Let's just have a bite here. It's completely different. It's nowhere close to what we have been having in Singapore. The one in Singapore is the dough is the centerpiece with the chicken inside it, but here the chicken is done very well, cooked very well, with a lot of tomatoes and onions and other things, and then it's put inside the pancake sort of a thing. So it's more like a cake rather than a paratha. But good, we'll finish this off and get back to you once we are done with our food. So we are heading out of our hotel once again. This time we need to get some money exchange. We have ended up finishing all our Malaysian ringgit that we had exchanged when we went to Borneo. So now we'll get some exchange and then head to some other parts. Nothing much. These 2 days are mostly going to be about leisure. A lot of exploration and work has been done over the last week. So today and tomorrow we'll mostly be at leisure. Go around here and there, mostly surrounded by food. So whenever we have to have food, we'll step out, and that's mostly going to be about that only.
We are in Jalan Alor now. You saw the crowd yesterday.
Cars. They're allowing cars now. In the night, it's closed.
Yes.
It's just a walking street at night.
And you saw what sort of crowd it was there yesterday. But now it's pretty light. Cars are going, and we are almost at our money exchange place as well. We'll just have to find a way to cross the road, and we should be there. So the restaurants are still open, but most of the pop-ups are gone.
Oh,
so we will come back in the night. So let's just cross. Let's just head to Pavilion Mall now. Alright, let me just put it on Google Maps. Pavilion Kuala Lumpur.
This side.
Okay, it's a 12-minute walk.
Can we go from inside this thing?
I don't think so.
Okay.
This is...
We don't know. For sure.
Huh?
Let's see how it looks.
Let's see how it is. We should go somewhere. So we are taking the subway. We will not ride the subway, but let's see if we can come out with another gate which is close to the mall. Unfortunately, the plan didn't work out. We'll have to step out and walk in the sun.
Yeah.
So let's get out.
From here, or do you want to get from here? Oh. Is this closer or is this far?
the streets. Oh, pavilion is just there.
Oh, good. There's a helicopter there. Is it seeming hotter than Singapore? Huh?
Humid.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're...
Oh, there's no money changes here.
And
so there's nitrogen ice cream.
We do have Pavilion Mall right in front of us. And we have spotted something interesting. What is it?
Nitrogen ice cream.
All right.
There.
So we have never tried that before, have we?
No.
All right, let's try that out.
This nitrogen ice cream from the Fuka, and we've got a wild berry flavor, so let's do a taste test. So I've seen these nitrogen ice creams only in the MasterChef, so good to try it out.
Should try a little more.
It's very creamy and very nice. It's quite refreshing, the flavor. It's got these really nice fresh berries flavor. Very creamy.
Pavilion Mall is right there. The tall building right there. So we'll head there next. Has been better than what we expected it to be.
Yeah, it's quite more modern.
Yeah. So surprisingly, having lived in Singapore for a year and then also touching base in Singapore for a day, and then from coming to KL, this looks like to be having a more exciting life. So
yeah, it's quite
people happening. Who have been to both KL and Singapore can actually tell us what they think, because it's to give a judgment, but yes, for the 1 day that we spent in Singapore and the day that we have started out in KL, this seems to be a better deal, both on the pocket as well as the experience.
Yeah.
Alright, let's take the main entrance. We found an interesting thing while after entering the mall is there's a bridge to the KL Convention Center. We are not really mall people, so we really didn't understand what to do inside there. We don't have any space on our luggage to take any extra stuff. We already paid for extra luggage twice in this trip.
More ice cream.
So, maybe some food here and take the bridge to the KLCC. It wasn't part of the plan, but here let's head to KLCC and then we'll see what's next. So I guess that's the bridge right in the front.
Oh, that's cool.
Again, lots of restaurants.
And ice cream.
And ice creams. So, but we have plans for lunch actually. We want to grab some traditional nasi lemak. And we have already identified a place for that. That's going to be a grab away for us. So we will be taking that, eating that once we reach there.
So here it is.
So we don't really want to eat anything here. Something interesting, something as unique as a nitrogen ice cream, yeah, we will try to go for that. But yeah, the bridge is right in front and we'll be taking that. Quite interesting to have found that.
Yeah. Saves us a lot of time walking in the sun.
Yes.
And it's quite humid here.
And we didn't have plans to go to KLCC now, but nevertheless, good option.
Yeah.
A great place for a photograph. So I'll take a photograph here for our Insta, so you can follow us on our Instagram. And you will get live updates on wherever we are traveling, irrespective of these vlogs that you're going to see. So that's going to come in different phases of time, but our Instagram is always active and live, and on wherever we are doing, wherever we are going on a day-to-day basis is what you'll be seeing over there. So this is a small clip that we are capturing, and if you are already on our Instagram, you must have already seen this clip with some nice music, Instagram music, to cover up this voiceover that I'm parallelly shooting on the phone as well as on the GoPro. So we are entering the main walkway now, which connects from the Pavilion Mall to the KLCC. So somehow we never entered Kuala Lumpur before. We have flown through Kuala Lumpur several times. When we went to Vietnam, or when we went to Bali.
Yeah.
To and from one of those routes. We have usually always gone via Bangkok and returned via Kuala Lumpur.
Because the transit is not that great of Kuala Lumpur Airport, we hate that. So we always had that impression that maybe, you know, when you have that first impression that you see of a city is not that impressive, then it stays on your mind, sticks to you. And that's why we never visited Kuala Lumpur. But yeah, this is changing. Our impression is changing because it's quite a happening and modern city.
So the challenge that we have always faced is whenever we have flown to other SEA countries through Kuala Lumpur, return through Kuala Lumpur home from one of those countries, it's always been on Air Asia. Surprisingly, not so surprisingly rather, the prices of Air Asia does entice you when you compare with the others, and we always end up booking that. And when you fly Air Asia, you have to go through KLIA too. So once you have flown through KLIA too, if you have already, you will know what a pain it is. Once you have completed all your checks and entered the boarding area, if you have entered the boarding area a few hours early, then you have it's just like almost like said getting inside a jail. You have nowhere to go, nothing to do. Just sit with a few cup noodles and a few cakes and some tea and coffee, pre-made tea and coffee at your disposal. Nothing else. I did very few comfortable seats available. So with that experience, flying to KLIA a couple of times, you've always avoided the country itself. Not a right thing to do, but this time when we had a few days open, we ensured that we do stay at least for a couple of days to break the jinx, change our mindset about it, and then take it from there. So we did that, and the first about 24 hours, not completed yet, but the first 20 hours or so have been wonderful. Jalan Alor from last night, if you have already seen the vlog, has been great. And tonight, to this morning has also been good. So yeah, we have another 30 hours or so before we head to the airport. So making the most of it.
So we're here at the KLCC. We're just taking the elevator down.
Escalator.
Oh, escalator down. There was a lot of walk. So in cities like this, it's, you know, you find these bridges and all, which are very convenient, but it's a lot of walk. So wear comfortable shoes, no matter what you're wearing, dress or whatever, just wear comfortable shoes, because you don't want to be struggling midway. So yeah. So we're going down somewhere.
Oh, so the aquarium is here.
Aquarium. Okay. Did the aquarium.
Lots of food options.
Yes.
We don't support any sort of wildlife viewing experiences in a closed environment, which is a zoo or an aquarium. So we'll avoid that and keep walking forward. It's like a food arcade. And they have Kenny Rogers roasters. Okay. We're having lunch here, so
no.
Is there any unique, interesting food that we can try?
I don't think so. It's more of Western food here.
Yeah. It's high fusion food.
Yeah, a lot of fusion. So we're not really after any fusion right now, because we want to try
So something connects to Surya, KLCC. Alright, pedestrian tunnel to Surya. So do you want to go to the KLCC park, or do you want to head to the Surya? The mall.
Do we have time, or do we need to go to lunch?
We have time, it's 2:12.
Okay, so let's go to Surya then.
Alright.
Let's check out the next mall.
Okay, let's go to Surya.
We took a very shortcut out of Pavilion, but I'm sure it's a big mall. Since it's a big mall, it's got a lot of...
So Surya and Pavilion, these are, I think, two of the biggest malls.
Yeah.
So we obviously do not have the entire time to explore all the malls entirely.
Yeah, but we'll show you a glimpse.
Yeah, we did check Pavilion. Now let's check Surya before we head out.
Yeah. We did go to the luxury side, so I'm sure there's another section with other brands. Because it's a huge mall.
Yeah.
But good thing we found that. Good thing we found the bridge to the towers. Because it's actually quite convenient. It's really good if you're walking in the mornings. You don't have to walk in the sun to do that. You can just take the tower connecting Pavilion to KLCC. I mean the bridge, not the tower, the bridge. And it's quite convenient.
So through Surya, we'll go out to the road and head to our next destination.
And if you didn't quite follow where how to get to the bridge, so you get in the main entrance of Pavilion, and just follow the signs. There will be a sign called to the KLCC bridge tower. Just follow that and that's how you get it.
Now we coexist over here, which is itself a task, because this entire network and the connection of the malls is together like a maze. So it's very easy to enter, but so difficult to find the right exit. So we just want to find a way out. Destination, but in the meantime I will keep the camera on and let's see what how this mall looks like. It's a brand fair here. You name the brand and you will find it. Can slightly spot Petronas Towers ahead on top of us. We're out. Alright, let's take the elevator and go to the top.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yes, there is it. Okay, there it is. Petronas Twin Tower visit. Let's go up. And that will give us a way out. Took another walkway to Surya and now we're finally getting out. Wow.
It's actually quite fascinating to note how everything is so connected. Like you don't have to even step out of the street to go from one huge mall to another and to one of the most, you know, popular tourist attraction here.
So we are in front of the Petronas Twin Towers.
Yeah.
And it has started
cooling. It's raining.
But yes, the towers are there, right behind us. As many times as you see it in pictures, seeing it in person is obviously a different experience. Wonderful. Okay. So there it is.
The rain has stopped. We took shelter under it only, under the towers, under the Twin Towers. So if you get lost and you don't know where you're exiting in the Surya Mall, from the Surya Mall, so once you see there it is, so once you come out of an exit and see the bunch of security there, you know that you've reached the right place. So there it is. the Twin Towers, it's huge. So no matter how many pictures or videos you see of it, nothing compares to actually seeing it in person. We always felt that it's quite overrated, but it's actually quite grand. There it is. And the best part is we just got out when it started raining, and we had the entire place to ourselves, just a few others, but it was almost empty. So we took a picture, which you'll see it on our Instagram, of me standing there and there's no one around. So yeah, if you can brave the rains, you should come during that time, so you'll get it all empty. That's a silly hack, but it works.
We have come to our next destination for lunch. So it's Nasi Lemak Wanjo in Kampung Baru. Yeah, chicken rendang.
That's okay.
Yeah. And what's this?
Spring.
Okay. Mungia, give me a spring, please. Honeydew smoothie, that's for me, and orange juice for her. And here's our two of our plates, beef lungs, and then there's sotong, which is squid. Then that's spleen, beef spleen, and chicken rendang, and obviously sambal is here. There is a fried egg here, as well as somewhere we have ikan bilis.
We are back to the Twin Towers at night. Okay, so here it is. Those are the towers there behind, all lit up. So we got a day view, and here's the night view as well. If you like this video, then please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel. If you want to see more of our travel and food content, and I also have an active Instagram page, so go and follow there. Drop in any questions that you may have. So yeah, see you in the next vlog.